everyone, I'm Shalaka Pawar and you are watching the True Gourmand. And in today's episode, I've come up with the best comfort food recipe ever, Dal Khichdi. It's simple, it's easy, it's quick and it's super tasty. So let's get started. Now to start with our khichdi, the first thing I've taken is rice 1 cup. I have washed this rice and this is like soaked washed rice. I had kept it soaked for around 10 minutes. And then this is moong dal, which I have also taken as 1 cup. This is also soaked and washed really well. Make sure that the quantity of rice and dal both is equal quantity. We are making dal khichdi, it's supposed to have a lot of dal. And that 1 cup need not be the baking measuring cup. Just take any vati or any bowl that you have at your house and just measure according to that cup. So the first thing that I'm going to do is now take this rice and put it in a cooker. Right, so I'm just going to add this rice in cooker. This I'm also going to add dal, right? So we're going to cook everything together. Now 1 cup rice plus 1 cup dal is equal to 2 cups. So I'm going to add in 6 cups of water in this. The water that we add needs to be 3 times the combination of rice and dal. So here goes 4 cups plus 2 more cups of water. That is 6 cups of water. Like so. Add some salt as per taste. Add turmeric powder, around 1/4 of a teaspoon. And then add a pinch of hing, asafoetida. That's it, that's all that we need in here. Just stir this a little bit. Here you go. And now we are going to close the lid of the pressure cooker. Make sure that you have the whistle on the top. And we are going to wait for 3 whistles and let this rice and dal combination cook well. Now in a pan, I've added some oil. And in this oil, I'm going to add some mustard seeds. That's right. A teaspoon of mustard seeds. And once they start crackling, I'm going to add a teaspoon of cumin seeds. That's jeera. Let them roast for a second or so. Now that they are cracking, I have cut 8 to 10 cloves of garlic in small pieces. I'm just going to add it here. And saute the garlic till it's light pinkish in color. Once the garlic has turned little light pinkish, I'm going to add an inch of ginger that I've grated. You can also do small pieces of this. And again, fry this for around 30 to 40 seconds or till the raw smell of ginger garlic completely goes away. Once our ginger and garlic is sauteed well, I'm going to add in 2 onions that I've just chopped vertically, some green chilies and curry leaves. I'm going to add all of it together. This is a no-fuss khichdi, so don't worry of what's going in when. Just saute these onions till they are translucent or till they are a little light pinkish, but we don't want to make it completely golden brown. A little light pinkish color is all we need on these onions. Now once these onions have turned beautifully pink and we've sauteed them well, I'm going to add a little bit more of asafoetida or hing. We had put in a pinch when we were cooking our rice and dal and now we've added another pinch. This just brings in so much flavor. So I'm just going to again mix this with my onions for around 10 seconds. I've roasted the hing as well. I'm going to add in 2 chopped tomatoes. Just look how colorful and vibrant this has started looking as soon as I've added tomatoes. It's also going to bring in a lot of flavor. So just mix these tomatoes with onions. And because tomatoes take a little longer to cook, what I'm going to do is add a little bit of salt. Only for this mixture. Remember that we've already added salt in our dal and rice, so don't add too much of salt. Only enough for this mixture and then saute this. Salt will basically help the tomatoes to cook faster. So I'm going to saute till the tomatoes are soft and cooked. Now as you can see, the tomatoes have mushed down. Now I'm going to add a little more of turmeric powder in this mixture as well. And very little bit of red chili powder. Now this is optional. If you don't like it, you don't put it. I add a little bit because the mixture of green chilies and red chilies actually tastes very good. But add little because you don't want your khichdi to be spicy or hot. Khichdi is supposed to be comfort food. So just add accordingly. I've just added like a little more than 1/4 teaspoon. I'm going to saute this really well till my spices are cooked. Now once the spices are roasted, this mixture is actually done. But this is the last touch that I want to add. A tablespoon of desi ghee. Khichdi is nothing without desi ghee. So this is like the most important ingredient. I'm just going to mix this with a tablespoon of nice desi ghee, that's clarified butter. My rice and dal are also cooked. I did 3 whistles. I let the cooker cool down a little bit and now I've opened it and again switched on the gas. And look how nicely this dal rice is done. See? It's quite sticky and nice. Now in this sticky dal rice that we have cooked, I'm gonna start adding the mixture that we just prepared. Here you go, just adding this entire mixture into my dal rice. And now I'm just gonna mix this through really well with the dal rice mixture. Now because this mixture is thick, I'm gonna add like 1 glass of water in it. You can of course add water basis the consistency that you like, but I think 1 glass of water works really well. And I'm just gonna mix this through so that this entire mixture loosens up really. Then I'm gonna let this cook for around 5 minutes, bring this entire mixture to a nice boil. Now the added water and the khichdi, everything's come together, it started boiling. At this stage, I'm gonna add in lots of coriander. Add lots of coriander because it brings in so much flavor to this khichdi. So here goes almost like a small cup of coriander that I'm gonna mix, right? And I'm gonna cook the khichdi again with coriander for around 2 minutes. And then with the coriander, I'm gonna add very little bit of garam masala. This is optional, but I like subtle flavor of garam masala in this. This is literally 1/8 teaspoon, so very little. You don't want garam masala to overpower the flavor, but that subtle flavor is just gonna bring out all the flavors of khichdi. So let this cook for around 2 minutes now. Now our khichdi is done, but just before serving, we want to add our last tadka to this khichdi, which is gonna just lift all the flavors of this. So before that, I'm just gonna add a dollop of ghee here. And once I've done adding a dollop of ghee here, this is this small tadka kadai that I have. I'm again gonna add some ghee in this kadai. Nice amount of ghee. And once we add ghee in here, we're gonna add some cumin, jeera. Let the cumin crackle. Cumin crackles, I'm gonna add in some crushed garlic. I've just basically crushed them a little bit and added, and then I have these 2 red chilies. I'm gonna add these red chilies as well and just mix this bagar. Now once our garlic is golden brown, I'm gonna switch off this gas and I'm gonna add like a small spoon of Kashmiri red chili powder. That's it. Just move it like this, let this mix well, and then this mixture goes in our khichdi. Amazing. Now all you have to do is just serve your khichdi. You can mix this really well and then serve it in a nice bowl with some onions, some papad and some achar. Our dal khichdi restaurant style is ready to eat. I really hope you like this recipe. Do try it out and let me know in the comment section how it was. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Instagram and also like my Facebook page. I'll see you guys in the next episode of True Gourmand. Till then, bye-bye.